Hello students, welcome back to the new video. Today we are going to see on cholas. Okay, we are going to have a closer look to the cholas. A closer look to the cholas. Here you can see, okay, this is the area where they were having the control over. Cholas were having control over the southern part of India. Okay, and it was, you can see here this lines which are been shown, okay, this type of lines which are shown, that depicts that this area is keeping on fluctuating. We cannot mark it as, okay, this much land is of this much king, okay. The empire cannot be denoted based on this, because you are having a fluctuating border which is there. Because kings used to have warfare for wealth, and they used to extend. Okay, if any king wins over the other, they get that territory in their hand. So this is how they used to have fluctuations in the whole map. Okay, we cannot fix it. Next, from Urayur to Thanjavur. Okay, from Urayur to Thanjavur. In the previous this thing, you saw. This is Urayur, okay. From Urayur to Thanjavur, this area they had the maximum control. The Cholas had the control. Now you have to understand the starting of the video. We started with the emergence of new dynasties in the north side. In the south side also, we had the same situation. Okay, how did Cholas rise to power? We had this king, okay. Pallavas were ruling over in this area, okay, in the south side, and Muttiyar was a Samant, and Vijayalaya was another Samant under Pallava king. Pallava was a king. He had appointed different Samants, okay, subordinates, or you can say the people who would look after that area. So Muttiyar and Vijayalaya, these are the two Samants who used to take care of the empire of Pallavas. So Muttiyar Samant, okay, to Pallavas hold power in Kaveri Delta, where Muttiyar were having control over. They had control over Kaveri Delta, which is in Thanjavur. They had control over the Kaveri Delta, where the river is flowing. Here, this part, okay. This area they had the control. Vijayalaya chiefly family of Urayur defeated Muttiyar and captured Thanjavur, and he was victorious. Here now what is happening? They take over, okay, the we can say Vijayalaya, he took over the Urayur family. Chiefly family of Urayur was defeated, and Muttiyar had captured Thanjavur. The whole part of Thanjavur was captured by Vijayalaya, and he was victorious in doing this. Thus he becomes the new king. Okay, he built the town of Thanjavur. Who built? Now we are talking about Vijayalaya. So he had built the town of Thanjavur. Once he conquered, he started building up the town and a temple for goddess Nishumbhasundini. Goddess Nishumbhasundini. So he had tributed. He, once he got the area territory, now he is building a temple for goddess Nishumbhasundini. The successors of Vijayalaya conquered the neighboring regions. Once you had means they had conquered over Thanjavur, now the neighboring areas which are there, they wanted to conquer that regions and kingdoms. Pandyans and Pallava territories were made part of Chola kingdom. Pandyans are also one dynasty and Pallavas are also one dynasty. They had control. Now Pallavas who were ruling earlier, okay, there were lot of successors who did not give away the whole territory. Few territories were there under them. So Pandyans and Pallavas territories were made part of the Chola kingdom. So they made a change. They made this every dynasty, okay, this two dynasties especially you have to remember, that is Pandyans and the Pallavas, they came under the Chola kingdom. Here you can see, okay, this area was captured and came under the rule, okay, Chola kingdom, this full area came under their control, and this side you can see this area came under their control, that is Pandyan and the Pallava regions territory came under their control. Further expansion took place under Rajaraja I. Now the famous kings who conquered over and who were the successors, okay, of Vijayalaya, okay, they were Rajaraja I. He is considered as the most powerful Chola ruler. Rajaraja I is considered as the most powerful Chola ruler. And you have to remember, this can be asked for 1 mark question. Here you can see the Cholas, okay, they had control over this regions, and I said about the Pandyans and the Pallavas, okay, the whole area they conquered over. And then you have the trade routes, okay, trade routes are this, all is the trade route, this blue mark which is there, that is the trade route. And then Chola territories, Chola territories are all marked, the Sri Lanka part, okay, that also comes under the Chola kingdom. Then you have the subordinates, this all area you can see, they went to the Indonesian side, and even in those time, okay, they had control over the navy. They used to go for wars, waging wars to the different territories, and they used to win over that area. So this much control they brought in through the strategy, planning, organizing, okay, everything they had decided and they have done. Okay, so we are going to see the next part, children. We'll be meeting in the next video. Till then, bye.